26 January 1971.
And what was your vision that time?
That time vision was to broadly speaking, to bring foreign and Indian students.
Foreign students.
Foreign and Indian students studying in Pune. Bring together these foreign and Indian students. And develop friendship among them.
Who are the other founders along with you?
Other founders were Dr. Tivari. My former school, I was in Ferguson College as professor. And I established Symbiosis in 1971 along with some of my past students and colleagues.
What do you think the role of the university should be? University ka role kya hona chahiye aapke
sath? I'll give you some background. See, Pune attracts large number of foreign students.
Yes.
Most of these foreign students come from upper-reaching countries. They face number of problems. First problem is admission to good colleges.
Yes, yes.
Admission, accommodation in hospitals, food, home sickness. And I realized way back in 1970 that these foreign students who come from opposition country were not treated properly by Pune people. Some of the black Africans felt that these students we are not only neglected, but often we are discriminated. For example, black students feel that Pune people like white students from America, England. But we are discriminated. They say that Pune people are as color conscious as Americans and Britishers. And that used to create bad impression in the minds of foreign students. So as professor of botany in Ferguson College, I realized that this is not good. They are our unofficial ambassadors of botany. When they will go back to their country, they should carry good impression. And therefore, with the help of some of my friends, I started a small organization called Symbiosis. Symbiosis means living together, coexistence, interdependence. And we started bringing foreign and Indian students together on various occasions like Raksha Bandhan, Eid, Bhaubeej. But afterwards, I realized that after this function, again, there was no dialogue between Indian and foreign students. So we started education institutions.
Presently, what is the size of the university and are you planning any foreign location branch?
At present, we have about 40 different institutions.
40 different.
Besides today, we have started our campus in Bangalore.
Yes.
In Karnataka, Hyderabad, in Telangana, Noida, in Delhi, Kashi, which is in Maharashtra. Now we are starting one center in Nagpur. So far we have not started centers abroad. But we have plans to start very soon.
For a location?
For a location. At present there is no. Branch of Symbiosis, abroad.
So where are you planning?
Maybe Oman.
Oman. And what is the strength percent of these students?
30,000.
Sir, what are the special achievement of the Symbiosis?
Special achievement of Symbiosis is our motto is Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam.
Yes.
World is what happens. And the first achievement is we have brought together foreign students and Indian students together. They stay together in hostels. They study together in libraries.
Yes.
You know, they play together on playground. So, by bringing foreign and Indian students together, we have to some extent achieved the concept of sahajeevan or coexistence.
Yes, yes.
Secondly, we attract large number of foreign students.
Yes.
Today, we have about 3,000 foreign students from 85 different countries.
85 countries.
85
countries.
And almost all states of India.
All states. Yes.
This is one thing. Second thing is, we send some of our students in foreign universities to study for a few months. And we also invite students from other countries like America, France, you know. Similarly, teachers from our university go abroad.
Yes.
Teachers from other universities come here to teach. So, this bringing foreign students together, bringing foreign professors on the campus to teach. The second achievement is, most of our institutions are very reputed.
Yes.
They are well known. Why they are well known? Because our weak placement in Symbiosis is very good. About 80 to 90% of our students find jobs in industry. Next achievement is we select professors and directors, principals, purely of merit, without caste, religion, region. Another distinguishing thing is we conduct all India entrance tests so that talented students across the country are selected.
Yes, yes.
Third, we give liberal scholarships to poor, needy, and talented students.
Means if there is a talented person without any resources, you help him to.
Yes, yes. No talented student.
Yes.
Who is poor goes without admission.
Sometimes I can also refer to such people.
Yes, yes, yes.
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Provided he gets good marks in entrance test.
Yes.
And no problem.
No, no problem. Sir, how do you consistently maintain the brand value of Symbiosis? It is a very strong brand. So how do you maintain it?
A strong brand is maintained over a period of 40 years. Symbiosis is 48-year-old.
Yes.
As I told you, we appoint good teachers, we attract talented students, we don't take donation or capitation for admission. Our students find placements in various industries. These are the things which have created a good brand for Symbiosis.
Yes, sir. Do you think with mushrooming private universities in India, quality of education has decreased?
You see, quality of education in India is decreased not only because of private universities. Don't think that all government universities and colleges are equally good.
Yes, yes, yes.
So, quality, all of quality education is there both in private universities as well as government university.
Yes, sir.
But among them, there are few universities, there are few colleges, uh-huh. both in private university and public university, yes. which are good.
Uh-huh.
As in case of America, in America, for example, there are 4,000 universities.
Yes, yes.
But only few of them are really good.
Yes, sir.
So, don't blame only private universities for reduction in standard. Uh-huh. Even government institutions are also equally responsible for falling standards.
Definitely. All are not like IIM, yeah. Ahmedabad.
So, similarly, some private universities are good, yes. some private universities are mediocre. It always happens. But let us not make a general remark that because of private colleges or private universities, the standard of education has fallen.
And what do you think, what is your suggestion to maintain the same quality of education and training all over India, especially the skills required by the employers? Because people are having the degrees but not the right skills.
Yes, you said it. And therefore our Prime Minister Narendra Modi has given the slogan, Skill India.
Yes.
We want to start skill universities, skill colleges, and every student should possess one or the other skill.
Yes.
Otherwise, he will not be good to himself, to his parents, or to the country. And therefore, I feel that every degree must be accompanied by one or two skills which are useful to the boy to get a job.
Yes, sir.
So, skilling is the answer.
In my opinion, presently we don't need the PhD holders, rather we need the skilled professionals to teach and train. What is your idea?
You are 100% right. There is no need of PhD.
Yes.
PhD is basically a research degree.
Yes.
A good researcher need not be a good teacher.
Yes.
A good teacher need not be a good researcher.
Yes.
What is required is a dedicated teacher who knows his subject and who knows how to teach his subject.
Yes.
PhD doesn't give that skill to the teacher.
But most of the advertisement mention, I don't think PhD should be necessary.
That is because UGC, University Grant Commission, insists that professor has to be a PhD. Associate professor must have PhD. And therefore, so many bogus PhDs are produced.
Yes, yes, yes.
In order to get jobs. I am against that.
Yes.
PhD should be necessary for professor who wants to do research.
Yes.
But it is not necessary for a professor who wants to teach.
Because yes, ordinary BSc or BCA may be an expert in IT.
Yes.
Which is M.Tech or PhD.
I entirely agree with you. But again I tell you that very often I say that there is too much of interference from University Grant Commission,
yes.
AICT. In fact, for every professional school, there is a council.
Yes.
There is a pharmacy council. There is law council.
Yes.
Bar Council of India.
Yes.
AICT.
Yes.
And they create funny rules which are not practical.
So, would you suggest such things to the UGC that there should be no PhD required? The focus should be on the skills.
Skills of teaching.
Yes.
Real
time, those who can transfer the real time skills.
Number of times these suggestions have been made to UGC.
Achha.
But UGC in its own wisdom don't agree.
They don't agree.
They are stubborn.
You have also given your suggestion
many times. I have written articles on that. I have spoken on many conferences. PhD is something, and you can't force a teacher to do PhD.
Yes.
It should come from within. teacher who wants to do some research and get PhD.
No, because it is the skills that are more important.
A good teacher may not like to do PhD because he has no skill. But he has good teaching skills.
Even if I am only a BA but I am expert in marketing or management, I should be encouraged to come and deliver the lecture.
I want further. Some of the persons who are working in the industry, they should be invited as teachers to teach in colleges.
Yes.
Because they bring their practical experience. For that PhD is not required.
Or suppose I have to teach the journalism, so if I am a journalist, I know better skills.
Why do you require PhD for journalism? We have many institutions of journalism at undergraduate level, media and communication.
Many directors of the media institutes are simply that.
Tell me how many editors of national newspapers are PhD?
Yes. There is no need. I
don't think any editor of any good national paper, newspaper like Times of India or Indian Express or Hindustan Times are the PhD.
One requires the right skills. Sir, what are the new projects in pipeline? Any planning to diversify in other areas of education or knowledge sector?
At present, we have plans to start courses in communication, soft skills. Because our students have no good communication. They have information in their brain, but they can't write, they can't express, they can't speak.
That's the biggest problem. Unemployment is because of the lack of soft skills. Communication and
soft skills. We want to give emphasis on soft skills. Then leadership. Soft skills and leadership.
You can also call me to train the students in this area.
As guest professor?
Yes.
Visiting professor?
I would be happy to, you can say.
You are in journalism for how many years?
I am 64 and I am in journalism for the past 30 years. And besides that, I have been the...
Now see, 30 years experience is much more important than PhD.
I have always been a visiting professor in communication, business communication and advertising, branding. This is my hobby, to train the people in especially soft skills. Because when I take the interview, I found that most of the people are having degrees but not the skills and soft skills. Which are required.
They do, but they can't express.
Today I am here and I am talking to you because of my communication and soft skills.
I tell my students, look here, communication is the key to success in life.
Yes, even Bill Gates has given his one line that you should have only the communication skill to succeed.
I tell you one thing, in 2014, Modi won elections.
Yes.
Simply because of effective communication.
Yes.
The way he used to speak, the way he used to act, the way he used to impress his audience. Communication is a big weapon.
Yes. It's the biggest weapon for leadership.
For everything.
For any professionalism.
For example, in advertising, you require communication.
Yes, it is the communication. That's why communication is required in all professions.
And that difference is sometimes urban students have some communication skills.
Yes.
The students coming from villages.
Yes.
They lack communication. And because of lack of communication, they may be intelligent.
But they are
they
not
may
able
be
knowing
to... good information in their brain.
Yes.
But they can't bring out that knowledge through communication.
Yes. And this is the biggest. I think this is the problem with almost 90% of the students.
Very true.
Almost 90% of the students. And are you really planning to go for other areas of knowledge sector like consulting or any?
Consulting is always there. We have several management institutions. Telecom management is there. IT management is there. MBA marketing is there. Finance is there. Computer is there. But personally, I feel that we should focus on more communication skills, soft skills, how you should dress, management, image management.
Yes, sir, image management. Yes.
That is required to be very important.
Actually, everything.
The way you clothe, the way you dress, the way you walk, the way you sit, the way you communicate, these things have become more important.
Image is the biggest thing. You can say ki, your image of this Symbiosis attracted me to talk to you.
Correct. Otherwise, you would not have come.
Yes. So, the image is very important.
Image is important for branding.
Yes. Without image, you can say nothing is possible. Like,
correct.
This is my.
You said it.
Because I am seeing that consistently this Symbiosis and other top institutes are maintaining their reputation for the past 30, 40 or 50 years.
Secondly, your infrastructure should be good.
Yes.
Hostel should be very good.
Yes.
Clean.
Yes.
Classroom should be good.
Yes.
Clean.
Yes, sir.
You know, it should be a pleasant atmosphere.
Yes.
Infrastructure.
Yes.
Is equally important. Nowadays, one more thing I have realized is students should learn more outside the classroom than inside the classroom.
Yes, yes.
Because what happens is, inside the classroom, a professor himself reads a book and passes on information to the students. But the true education is experiential education.
Yes.
A student should have experiential education. What do I mean by experiential education? That he should go out of the classroom.
Yes.
He should meet people.
Yes.
He should visit industry.
Yes.
He should do things on his own and learn by doing. Learning by doing. I call it experiential learning.
Yes.
So there should not be teaching, there should be more learning and less teaching.
This is the core thing which is required for leadership, success.
Which with experience is your best guru.
Yes.
You learn more out of your experience.
And there is no substitute for experience.
There is no substitute for experience.
Yes, definitely.
So every experience, small or big, teaches you a lesson.
But here in India, what is happening? People are just getting the degrees and they want placement without any skills and without any soft skills, and that's why I think the youth unemployment is there.
Correct. I call it educated unemployment.
Yes, yes. And I think the biggest problem with teachers, those who are so-called PhD teachers or like that, is they are not guiding the students properly that these are the your skills required by the employer.
Because the reason is, we have poor teaching, poor quality of teaching is a big problem for our country.
Yes.
A student wants first either doctor, engineer, MBA. No, who wants to be a teacher in life?
Yes.
No student,
yes.
No parents would like their son or daughter to be a teacher in school or professor in college.
And this is again.
So, if I don't become a doctor, if I don't become a good engineer, if I don't become a phalana, then my last choice is be a teacher.
Yes.
You should not be school. In America, in good university, in many countries, teacher's job is highly respected.
Highly respected and highly paid also.
They are highly paid.
Yes.
They are highly respected by society and therefore students and government. Here in India, teacher is the last teaching is the last option.
It should be first option.
First option. And if it has to be first option, the teacher should be the person who is paid highest.
Yes.
He should have job security.
Only then the things
you should command respect from government, society.
Yes.
In good old days, teachers were not getting good salary,
yes,
but they were highly respected by the society.
Yes. People, we have to change the people's mindset, attitude to for the right people.
I often say that parents may give you a biological birth.
Yes.
But your teacher gives you second birth.
Yes, yes. Yes, definitely.
Punarjanma we call it. Parents give you biological birth.
Yes.
But second social birth
yes.
is birth only by teacher.
Yes.
Teacher shapes your destiny.
Mm-hmm.
Parents don't shape your destiny.
Yes.
And therefore, teachers should be highly paid, highly respected, right? Good. Good person should have first choice to be a teacher.
Yes.
To be a professor.
Yes. Yes.
And that is happening in our good American university, good British university, even good Chinese university.
Sir, I have no question related with your interest. What are your interests, hobbies?
My hobby is reading, thinking. Thinking of future, thinking about youth,
yes.
And always thinking of, I'm always thinking of innovation.
Yes, yes.
What new thing
yes.
I can do.
Because innovation is the biggest
thing. Innovation is the biggest thing. Yes. Innovation is the driver of
yes.
prosperity.
Yes.
Innovation is the driver of economic development.
Yes. Every area innovation.
So I always say, what new institution I should establish, what new program I should start, and then I start consulting senior persons, experienced persons. So I always, what I have coined the term, I call walking management.
Yes, yes, yes.
When I talk to you, I learn something from you. Every new person gives me something new.
Yes, definitely.
So these ideas are really important.
Yes, sir.
And I spend most of my time in reading, thinking, and thinking about innovation.
But I'm really lucky to able to learn something from you right now.
Both ways.
Yes, both ways.
Both.
Yes, both. Even sometimes we can learn from the small child or.
Yes.
Because.
Everything, innovation is the real driving force.
Yes, yes.
New idea.
Yes.
And humanity has progressed because of innovation only. Birds are flying.
Yes.
Why we can't fly? So aeroplanes were invented.
Yes, yes.
Fish are swimming.
Yes, yes.
Why can we not?
Yes, yes.
So boats and ships were invented.
Yes, yes.
So all major inventions are innovations.
Mm-hmm.
All major inventions are innovations.
Yes, yes. Sir, what's the involvement of your family members like sons and daughters?
I have two daughters. Elder Dr. Vidya looks after our university. My second daughter Swati has started two universities.
One in Indore, right?
One in Indore, Madhya Pradesh.
Yes.
That is called University of Applied Sciences.
Yes,
and second in Pune itself, which is called Symbiosis Skill University.
Yes.
And both are still private universities.
All daughters are involved with
My wife is looking after Dr. Ambedkar Museum. We have established a beautiful Dr. Ambedkar memorial. And you know, it is very unique. Why? Because wife of Dr. Ambedkar has donated his personal belongings, clothes,
yes.
tables, utensils, Bharat Ratna, his citation of Bharat Ratna. Oh, it's a beautiful museum.
The museum is at Pune.
Yes, 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 very close. Half a kilometer from this place. Achha. You should go and visit that.
I would like to meet some of your teachers, students also.
Yes, yes, yes. You can meet them.
interaction with them. And especially your director of media institute.
For that you have to go to Lavali, where it is about 20 kilometers from this place.
20 kilometers? Yeah. Achha, dur. If...
In Vimandagar, there is undergraduate media communication.
Achha.
You can meet him, Gopal Krishna, the director. Achha, Gopal Krishna.
If can have arrangement from here...
if you want to talk to him, you can speak to him. I will ask my PA to contact him.
I can go from here to meet him. Your entity is any...
Yes, telephone you can talk to him.
Telephonically.
You can go personally.
I would like to meet personally.
That is better.
Your arrangement can be from here, means
I will ask my PA.
So, and what about your, especially personal interest, can you go for some cooking or playing or?
Reading is my habit.
Reading is the habit.
I walk.
You walk.
I do some yoga sadhana.
Yes, because to keep you here.
I am now 84.
Yes, so you have definitely keep yourself fit through yoga and. And you have won many prizes, including Padma Bhushan and Padma Shri.
Padma Bhushan.
Yes.
Kundi Bhushan. Kundi Bhushan is the local.
Local
award. Supposed to be prestigious.
So I congratulate you and I wish you for a very long life.
Thank you.
Even 1,000 years. Thank you, sir. I enjoyed talking to you and I learned a lot of things from you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much and I will try to meet you again.
Please.